Hello, gamers of the Game Report. So actually, it turns out that I've had my first day. I had 2.5 hours of sleep. So I'm talking about school in this situation. So I go to university. I'm in Canada, and I had my first day of my second semester where I have 7 courses. My first day was 3 classes, an hour class, and a 3-hour class. But then my bus takes 2 hours to get there, 2 hours to get back. So I was out for about 9 hours of school. So it turned out that I had 2.5 hours of sleep going back to school. I did school that day, had no homework to like really think about, and it turns out that I slept 5 hours, and here I am making another video because I can, because I don't actually have anything to do till today. I go for 10, so I leave at like 8, and right now it's 2 in the morning, so I pretty much. I'm just going to be playing Minecraft for you guys, continuing to get the uploads up, and hopefully my schedule doesn't get too busy, and it remains being stuff in classes and stuff, you know? So I temporarily turned off the village farm because I actually found out that the auto spawner is taking 600 RFs a tick, and it's actually it takes a lot of power, and I don't feel like using a ton of power for my spawner right now, since the grinder is already taking a pretty decent amount. So what I was trying to make is the, heat vents. That was what I was leaving off in the last episode. So we need to make 27 of these, which makes 27 of these. So obviously the first one is we need to make coils. So I have 24, which means I don't have enough of this, so we can get 12 motors. I shouldn't make it yet. I should get more copper and run it through the metal former. So I actually didn't know if I'd have enough copper coils yet. So that there we go. I do not have enough. Let's get a chest. I want to actually have a chest to store some of this stuff temporarily because it's going to be a lot of my inventory space. Let's put the gold away. We'll keep that. Throw that back. Also, the fuel rods. I actually think I should make the next step, or the next fuel rods. I mean, the, like, yeah, let's make the shit that I put in. So, let's get my hazmat suit. I need to get all my uranium. So we have 48. 48, and then I'll take out all this uranium. I don't know. Okay, let me just look this up actually really quick. Uranium. Let's get enriched uranium fuel. We'll can it. So over here I have the fluid solid canning machine. This is fluid enriched. This is canning. So I put this, I put that, and we get it canned. Easy peasy. Then I'll need to thermal center. So over here I had the rock crusher and I was doing my uranium. So we're going to continue processing the rest of it. So I need my ore washing plant, and we need to do this, which means I need to add the water back to it. Where did I put that? Oh, here it is. Okay. I need something to place underneath so it'll, so I can place the transfer node. All right. There we go, keeping the water up. I also want to, I can't pull this out actually because of how I'm giving it the water, so that sucks, but, yeah, I don't know another way to do it. Whatever, we'll just casually come over here and take out the stuff whenever I can. It's not, like, super slow, so that's okay. So we'll let that go, I'll put in the rest, we'll just constantly take out that stuff and we'll be good. I think. Okay, let's make the rest of the plates, or whatever. So, over here I have the copper cable. Let's make the rest of the coils. So heat, vent. It needs a space. Okay, so let's make this. Whoops. I want this. There's another 11, so I needed 27 motors, so we'll make the 17 for now. What was I missing from here? Nut tin item casings. Oh, we're missing coils actually. I need 54 coils, so we need even more copper processed. So I have to use all of it. This is actually really expensive. Oh my god. I need to check this chest and hope I have coal. I mean, copper? I do not. So now I have to hope that I have copper in the. Okay, let me just. 1 second. There we go. Let me put the uranium away for now. And we'll switch out my armor, and then we'll go see if my miner has gotten me any copper. I think it has. I think I remember seeing that it has it had copper in it. This is why we also continue using the miner. We need this to keep getting me more copper and stuff and resources. Okay, so yeah, back here I had 37 and a stack, because it does the top layers first, and it's at the height of 33, which I think is like copper's done now. So that's all the copper I'm gonna get from that miner. Okay, so let's process this real fast. Boom. Boom. You can touch purified crushed uranium ore without it doing anything, so that's cool. I kind of want to add like a hopper to this, to a chest. Hopper. So chest. Let's make one. Let's make two. No, make one. We'll just make a hopper. Okay. And then I need iron out. Let's grab some iron. Let's get a stack. Okay, so I'm gonna go from back here and I'm gonna attach the hopper. So that should keep it outputting, and then we put all the purified uranium in, and I don't think there's any more. So now I also want to get the uranium out of here, process the rest of that through the crusher. Yeah. The rock crusher. It's the best way to process it, I think, if I remember correctly. And then there's no way to really make this any better. This is just the best it can be. Which we're getting it here. So that'll make me more of the fuel rod shits. We have 16 here actually already, so that's really good. That's basically 8 dual. I'm not sure how many I can make, but we'll continue making the rest of the stuff. So there's my copper. Let's make some more coils. 9 more, so that makes me 5 more electric motors. So we have 22. I need 5 more. So I need this copper. I think another 30 is enough, right? I had 24. Okay, let's do 24. There we go. We'll save the rest of the copper and just use it as I need it. Also, these amount of copper plates isn't enough. I'm gonna need 27 times 8. So let's actually look at what this cost is, and I'll do the exact number. Oh, it is enough, because I needed 4 stacks, a little bit under 4 stacks, and I have a lot more than 4 stacks, actually. Did I have enough iron plates? Yeah, I think so. Okay, let's throw this shit in here. Let's check this for my copper cable. So we'll make the rest of the motors, or the coils. That was actually 4. I needed one more. So I need one more copper, basically. Because that'll give me... No, I need 3 more copper. Yeah. That should give me enough cable. Oh, it was 2 each. Okay, yeah, it was right with only 2. Okay, yeah, we're having an exact number at this point. Okay, so heat vent. Coil. Electric motor. So then we need iron bars and the iron plates. Let's get iron bars out. Let's just get a stack of iron and we'll make bars. I think that's enough. Okay, so heat vents. We have all 27 in there. Let's throw the extra stuff in here for now so I can take this out. 27. There we go. Boom. So then we need this, and we need to start crafting them into the next one. And wow, that's super annoying. Yeah, you know, I need to just take out all of it basically. So this should work for making them. And now I just need to. Can I just do this? Nope. So I have to actually click one at a time. I thought you would be able to W click into it, maybe. Whatever, 27 of this recipe, not a terrible thing. I think the gold one is only then 2 stacks of gold plates that I needed. So that's not as expensive. To be more exact, it was 108 or something I needed. This is pretty quick. By the way, the reason I go all the way to overclocked ones and not the advanced, they actually have more cooling than the advanced when it comes down to it. For some reason, the overclocked is the best one, in my opinion. That's what I found when I was doing testing. Which I created this design on my own, and it was overall the best for what I needed for a reactor. Okay, let's get the gold out. So now we'll do half of it, half of it. Oh, wait. Like that. There we go. Only 27 times on that. Could be worse. I did use like literally all of my gold, all of my copper, a ton. The iron wasn't a big deal anymore. I used to have a problem with iron. Yep. So then I was also thinking about the ender quarry, and yeah, if I want to get an ender quarry, I'm gonna need diamonds. That's pretty much gonna be like my bottleneck on a lot of things. It's always been a bottleneck when I play this pack. I don't know what it is, but I think they like turn down the amount of diamonds you get, or something. 'Cause man, or every recipe needs more diamonds. Basically, that's the other thing. That's what it appears to be. So there's my 27 overclocked heat vents, and I can actually put these in. Holy shit, that's backing up. Okay, let me take this, put this on, I mean. Let's take out all this for a second. Throw it in here. I just want to make sure it's not backing up. Alright. There we go. Cool, so that'll keep going. I want to get the rock crusher stuff, the crushed. Let's run it through the ore washing plant and see if I can keep the thermal centrifuge going without it turning off. Did I kill my power or something? No. Wow, this uses more than 512 EUs a tick to keep both going. I think it's because of the amount of overclockers in that. Yeah, that's a lot better. So that's keeping that going. That's pretty impressive. Well, now I'm not wearing, I mean, I don't have any uranium on me, so I can switch back just to move the purified over and have inventory space. So, boom. Am I gonna keep doing this for all 17? How's this doing? It's not backing up right? I don't think so. It's really gonna let that go while I put in the reactor heat vents. So I have this thing up. I'll put it in. So basically, it's here, here. It's a really weird design, but I came up with this myself and I really like it. So don't hate me for it. It's an extremely weird design that slightly you when you first look at it, you'd be like, there's gotta be a better way. Nope. I even took out some of the reactor heat vents to save on resources. And there's going to be holes in this, which I have to fill up with, like, reactor plating and stuff. So, yeah. I literally took out as much of the reactor heat vents as possible. That, and that, and this one. There we go. So then I need exchangers and plating. It's almost back up to heat. Let's change out my armor to get this out. Okay, so I think I want to make the rest of the fuel rods. So let's get all my uranium out. Wait, what? I put it in here. I was like, what did I do? Fuel. There we go. 58 more. Nice. What about the rods? Let's get those. Let's put it in the canning machine. There we go. Let's put this shit away. Alright, I think we're good. So now I just need to make the other reactor stuff. So, overclocker. No. What the fuck? Exchanger. Heat exchanger. We need this one. So we need to make a normal exchanger. And then the the component one. Okay, so this is an electronic circuit. Let's get those out. We have 7. And then I also have tin plates and copper plates. Okay, tin. We have 43. Pretty good number. I use the other tin plates to make the tin item casings. I need 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Not expensive at all, actually. Okay, and then that one, so I need the rest of the gold, and we'll make 4 of these. We'll just, I was like, oh, it'll shift click. Oh, wait, it doesn't stack. There we go. There we go. So that's all of that, super easy. And then the last one is the reactor plating, which is this. Basically, I'll be using the cheapest one, so I think it's Advanced Alloy is the cheapest one, because these take shit tons of resources, or the other one is included. So, lead plate plus Advanced Alloy. Lead plates, Advanced Alloy, 4 of them. I need more lead plates. Let's get 2 more. Let's make this. Oops. No, no, no. Okay, let's just craft this together. Super easy. There's my reactor plating. So now we have to put these in. That's why I tried to like save some space. So this is the interesting part. Reactor heat, like the component heat exchangers, basically pulls heat out of the thing and puts it onto these heat vents, which actually makes it super efficient. And then these platings are actually just to fill the space. There's no other purpose for these platings. So now we just have the dual fuel rods as my extra, and I think I need 19 of them to fill this reactor up. So it's not super bad. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I can just connect this to the thing, put in the fuel rods, and be good to go. Which would mean there's something I'd need to turn on to start using that power. But yeah, we have a ton of fuel rods to go into this thing, so let's make the rest of them. Fuel. We might as well can everything. Everything that I have of uranium. I need more fuel rods. There they are. Might as well process it all. So, this is going to give me too much power, because this is going to be 380 RFs a tick, I mean EUs a tick, which is 1600 RFs. It's going to be an insane amount of power coming into the system, so I'm not even sure if this cable is going to be able to handle it. I don't know how the gold cable works with this stuff, so keep that in mind, bear with me here. I might have to figure out something else to do. I might have to use like HV just till the like the thing from here. I don't know yet. It's not super far to travel anyway, so throw this shit in there, throw that in there. We need all the plating, so I basically need to take plating plus the fuel rods, and that gets me 33 of them. So now we can. Oh, we had more. Okay, let's also do it here. Can I do it like that? Nope. Has to be in a crafting table across the top, or any row really. Okay, so now I should be able to put these into the thing and pull them out. So I want to use like a diamond translocator or something. Okay, let's do that. We'll filter it. I think I only need one. And then we also want translocators. So I don't think I have any yet. Okay, yeah. So we'll make two. So this recipe twice. Let's make sure I have the circuit board. Nope. We need it from here. We have the gold, we have the iron. What else am I missing? Redstone chipsets, have it, and ender pearl. Okay, so ender pearls, intricate circuit boards, redstone chipsets. I think it's the gold on the sides and iron on the bottom. Iron on the sides, gold on the bottom. There's four. I got my translocator. I need two chests. We'll make some. Okay, then I need the gold cable. Get like a few. All right. So I don't know if it's like per connection or something. I hope it is. Just like the kind of connect, like the thing how other cables work. Otherwise, it's gonna mess up. So, there's an issue here that I can't actually. Let's just show you guys how this will work. So have those translocator here in the bottom. So this one could be the insert whatever. It'll insert the fuel rods. Sure, that's fine. It'll turn on when I click this lever. So now we're getting 380 EUs a tick. I actually have no way to know if this is wasting power or not. And then this is the interesting part. So I have to diamond nugget this, and I have to filter out. Oh God. Fuck! I have to filter out used fuel rods, which I'm not sure if I can do it from the NEI. Let me try actually. Depleted nuclear fuel rods. Oh, you can. Okay, I'm good. Alright, cool. There we go. Let's fix this. How did it stack? How the fuck? Oh, wait, no. Never mind, you could stack those. No, you're not supposed to be able to. Wait, how did I stack them? Oh, it's because they're used now. Yeah, okay. Let's throw this shit back in again. God damn it. Okay, this shouldn't be very hard, whatever. I didn't know if you could actually filter it from there, so learned something new today. What the fuck? It's like cooling off heat. I don't know. I think that's right. Okay, and then here. Alright, and now we just put in all the fuel rods. Alright. Let's put in the singles first. And then those. Okay. So now I could turn this back on and it'll only finish when it empties or depletes them. Okay, cool. So we're running basically 40 dual fuel rods and this should be pretty insane. So that's all my uranium, I'm pretty sure. So that when that runs out, I lose that power. But I do get plutonium out of it, which is very nice. So I think now is a good time to throw all my extra stuff that I didn't need for this back into the system. Then I'll look at, well, I want to switch back. I switch back my armor already. I want to look at my quarry and how it's doing. Not my quarry, but the miner. There we go. Let's eat some food. Let's look at my ore in here. So we have this shit, charcoal, rubber. Okay. I could probably turn back on the villager farm actually now. So I think I put the safari net in my system. Yep. So I'll put that back in, since now I should have the power to keep it spawning. Okay. And then watch when this idle runs down, how much power, well, you can't actually see it, but it uses a lot of power, okay? Just accept it. Like, every 26 works. Every, like, second and a half, it's using 600. So it's crazy power. So I actually have no way to know if this stuff is working or not. Because I'm not using enough of my power right now. And I'm sure if I go up here, these buffers are going to be full too. How is that possible that I... So just my reactor's enough power to supply my entire base right now. So let's look at that mining laser. Or laser. Laser. Because I could start feeding power into a laser, technically. So what's expensive here? Diamonds. Diamond. And slime crystal. We need pink slime. How do you get pink slime again? It's the butcher? No. Mine factory reloaded. Slaughterhouse. I need to make one of these. So a bunch of Invar. Machine frame, redstone reception coil. Machine frame. Oh, we should make some more. What am I missing from making more machine frames? Iron chipsets. And then the steel. Coal. Let's grab, let's craft another hopper. This time it's going to be from the top. Green coal and the iron. Okay, so we'll get a stack of steel, which we'll use to make steel plates. Okay, and then over here, steel plates, and we can do it in the compressor after. Okay. I actually want to go get all the ore and stuff out of here and start processing it already, since I have the power. I have the power! There we go. So we sag mill the coal and the diamond. I mean, and the Certus quartz. I need to look at how to process the dense coal, if I can just sag mill that too. Yeah. What about the dense iron? The rest of it seems to work, so the only thing is I'd like to disable that, change this to orange while I do that one redstone, I mean iron. Change that back to yellow, that to red, and then we just run all this through it. Okay. There we go. I actually wonder how my power is doing on this. Processing all of this shit. So I could actually check it back here. We have the capacitor bank. Then we have these. And these buffers are pretty much full constantly. So that's really cool. We have the steel plates. Let's put them in here. Extra steel from here. Extra 55. Probably should make more. Even more. And more steel. So coal. Oh, let's take another 2 stacks. And then another stack of iron. Just because I can. There we go. Let's get this. There we go. So this reactor will run for 2.5 hours. It's not going up, right? This is stable, right? It's supposed to be. It dropped to 490 at its lowest, 310. Yeah, we're good. It's just cycling the heat around through the stuff. Okay, cool. Just making sure. That scared me. It was going up. I was like, what? What? Quickly, I want to check these to see if it is now using, like, power. 98. It's going down. Going down. Going down. So it seems to work. Somehow, I think it's on a connection basis. It's not a, like, cable thing. You can actually use, like, all the power. So that's cool. I don't know. So we'll also start up my lasers, which I could probably speed up. I could also run these probably like 24/7 now. So that'll make a couple machine frames once I get tin thingy. Let's take that thing from the ore washing plant. Put it on this one. So we need a piece of dirt temporarily for this. Put that in, remove the dirt, put it back, and now we can make more of this, but with tin now. Let's get a stack of tin. Let's get 3 stacks of tin and some redstone. I should probably process all this redstone too. Okay, so in here, this, and then this. Missing recipe. Okay, there we go. Let's get redstone. Another 7. So I have to figure out how to process this dense to get ore, so I could just pulverize it for 4. Okay. So let's just do that first. Let's run this all through. Okay, so it'll be slow, but it'll get me the redstone that I need or want. And it gets me cinnabar at the same time, which is even better. Wow, that processed really fast, all the ore. I wonder if there's any more ore in the system that I need to process. Or I haven't processed any of the yellorium. Okay. Might as well. Just in case I want to use it later, it'll be processed. So we could also take this shit and throw it back through. Okay, this is probably going well. Oh, wow. So I should probably disable that function after and
start doing coal.
Wait, let me check something. Pulverizer, this, you can't cook it, right? Alright, so we shouldn't have a problem. Okay, it'll obviously back up, and I'll just fix that when it's done. So yeah, we'll just turn all this to pulverized. We'll also take this shit, throw it in my system. This is the time to use power, basically. Okay, so slaughterhouse. We pretty much have everything. I just need wood. We'll use this wood for now. And we also need the last thing. What the hell was it? Oh, an Invar gear and plastic sheets. Pronounced X shades. Let's get the 4. And invar gear. So let's get 4 for an invar gear. Okay. We'll have to stop it to run a gear through this after. Oh, let's pour a whole thing to try to empty this. How's this doing? 188 gold. Nice. Wow, is it not emptying? Oh, we got the invar in there. Okay, let me change this for a second. Let's get the gear cast. Okay. Put this down instead, change it back. Okay, we're good. Let's continue. Let's throw my emeralds in my system as well. Good 300 emeralds, not bad. Not bad at all. So there's the invar gear, let's start making it. So I have to make sticks. So we need 2 axes. Let's get that. 1, 2. We also need the swords. 1, 2. Let's start crafting. Invar gear. Machine frame, actually. Invar gear. Restaurant reception coil. And it's plastic sheets up here. This down here. And that's how you work out a recipe. Okay, so I have a slaughterhouse now. Basically, I want to use this now for temporarily instead of the grinder. Yeah. So I need to disable this for a second. I need to run this one instead. So that'll now get me pink slime. Shouldn't be that long of this. Okay. And I need a bucket. So then we'll take that pink slime, we'll spawn a slime, we'll safari net it, and then use that in my auto spawner. Safari. I need to make one gas tier. Ender pearl. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. All right. Wow, that's pretty slow. I wonder what the chance of getting pink slime is compared to meat, since I'm getting so much fucking meat. God damn it. We could totally make meat blocks, guys. I should make meat blocks, right? Okay, oh, there's the coal. So now I want this to go down here. Turn that off, and we'll process all that coal. Cool. A little bit more. Add that to here. Let's grab. Throw this back through. Alright. That's pretty good. So I'm actually curious, what would it take for me right now to get to, oops, I need that for the pink slime. What would it take right now for me to get to an ME system? I think it's a stupid amount of diamonds, right? Like, that's kind of one of the big things that's holding me back. What is it? I think I'd want, do I want an ME system before a quarry? Let's look up ME controller. It was like, the iridium's not a big deal. I'm not even going to look at the iridium right now. It's everything else. I can make the endurium, I can make the vibrant. The scenarium is actually a pretty big deal. And the irradiant uranium. That amount of glowstone and uranium ingots I need. Oh god, maybe I shouldn't have processed my uranium and made a reactor yet. How much uranium do I need? Well, I know I can get a lot, so that's decent, I guess. I should probably like some figure out how to advance miner the Nether. I should get a tesseract, like two tesseracts. I think that would help me a lot. It's not that bad, right? It's the end stone, and I've made end stone already. Kind of a interesting thing to think about. Very, very interesting. Yeah, how's my farm doing? I forgot that the farm takes a lot of durability as well. I mean, power. Wow, we already have 1,000. Is that all the stuff I need for the... Wait. Galgadorian. Oh yeah, I'll need all those gas tiers. Fermented spiders are fine. Magma cream, I'm gonna need to get slime balls or something. So I need to make like a slime farm, which is kind of what I'm doing with the pink slime. Or coagulated blood, which I could actually probably do, which would be easier, I think. We almost have 1,000. So I'm just gonna empty out the other shit, this meat. Let's take this out. Alright, now we're just waiting for the slime. Oh, meat went up again. Pink slime's almost there. We're gonna have get rid of this and replace it with pink slime. Does this actually use less power? Well, it doesn't get items, so never mind. It's irrelevant. Where did I put the grinder? Actually. Did I put it in here? Wait, what the hell? Where did I put it? I broke it and I didn't get it? What? It trash canned it, didn't it? The fucking transfer node picked it up. Wait, it doesn't even have stack upgrades. I mean, world interaction upgrades. How would it be able to pull items? There's meat and there's the slime. So let's replace this. We'll get pink slime. I don't actually know what happened to my grinder. What if a zombie picked it up and then it ruined everything? Okay, so let's replace this with this. We're going to also replace what's inside this with, I guess, pink slime. Okay. So now I want to take this out, put it in. Oops. Put it in, take it out, put it in, take it out, put it in. Alright, so now we're just getting pink slime out the wazoo, and we're good. Let's also check this. So we're fine. Alright, let's use this pink slime that I'm getting. So here we go. Pink slime block. We cook this. Oh, we get a pink slime crystal. So now I can make that miner that I wanted. I just won't look at the ME controller yet, okay? We'll just leave it. Just leave it. Okay, so I need. Oh, wait. I got a lot of gold. I'm pretty happy about that. Okay, so what did I need for a mining laser? It shouldn't be that hard, right? I should probably be able to do this by the end of the video. So, oh yeah. Do I have emerald upgrades? Can I make some? Storage. Template. What is it? Whatever. That should be fine. Okay, so we have the redstone reception coils, the plastic sheets. Let's actually make more. So I have some rubber here. Let's cook that down. Let's get the rocket fuel separately. So let's take these. We're just gonna throw back all the stuff that I'm not specifically using right now. All right, that's fine. Okay, so let's get buckets. We'll do four at a time, I guess. Unless I can make more. We'll make two more. Six at a time. So we need the plastic sheets. the plastic, raw plastic, and the compressed wood sawdust thing. Let's look at sawdust. Okay, do I have any in here? Yep. So let's turn this into compressed. Then we'll turn all of that plus the plastic that I make into plastic sheets. That's why I made so much. I was trying to make sure I can make a lot of plastic sheets in my first go of this and not waste time. Okay, so this. Oh, I never cooked it yet. Let's do it. Come on. Okay. By the time I put it in this recipe, I'm sure a bunch of it will be processed. I probably also didn't do this right anyways. Yep, it's backwards. You can count on me. I was really just buying time for my plastic, obviously. Okay. So we're at 14. We'll make the rest of it, so we'll just get more buckets of rocket fuel since I have it already. Plastic. Okay. Amazing. Let's get a few more buckets. There we go. I'm sure this won't be enough plastic sheets anyway, so. Okay, there's my plastic sheets. We'll leave those. We'll put the buckets of rocket fuel in here. Pink slime crystal. Okay, so now I need to make the mining laser. So, we have the redstone reception coils, diamonds. We have. Let's get all four. Let's get my 22 diamonds out. We'll just pulverize these. Should be fine. Let's take this shit out and make some room. Okay, so we have diamonds. We're good. Let's also get the rest of the stuff. So, redstone, reception coils. Let's take three. Let's get plastic sheets, hardened glass. Get a few. And then we need these. So, it's an illuminator frame, so it's hardened glass. Nether quartz and signalum. Well, we have the signalum. We have the hardened glass. We need nether quartz. Okay, so it's this, 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 this. So we need how many of those? Two, three, and one extra per. So I'll get four. We need more hardened glass. And we need to fill these with glowstone. So I need to put 500 for each. So glowstone, that's two per. We need eight. Okay, magma crucible with this. I actually wonder how are my capacitors doing up here? Or these things, the kinetic gens? Oh man, they're full. What the fuck? I'm still not using enough power. Let's temporarily turn off the reactor then, because I'm just wasting the power. I'd like to not waste if I can. So now it might be actually touching the power, since all the stuff I'm using. We have a lot of diamonds. Nice. What was I waiting for? The thing over here. We have four of them now. Okay. Let's make. Okay, we can make that. Should be pretty easy. Plastic sheets. I think one hardened glass and diamonds, yeah. Alright. Mining laser. Laser drill. Then we need the prechargers. So, It's a pink slime crystal. This shit. So we need electrum. Two electrum. We need redstone. 19, eh? Okay. Two of those. We have the hardened glass, we have the luminaire, we have everything. So let's put it together. Pink slime. This. Illuminator. Hardened glass and diamond. Visitor drill, precharger. Okay, cool. So now I need to figure out how I'm gonna like connect this up. Because this is going to be pretty interesting. I believe the math was that it's good to put it at the height of 120 or something. So let me check on the wiki. Please be patient with me while I quickly look this up. It shouldn't take me very long. It is better when mined over 128 or more blocks above bedrock. Okay. Uh-huh. And then I don't actually have a way to transport the items back down. So that sucks. But, how am I also going to... I'd have to make, like, an MFE or something to be able to bring the power up there. MFE. Let's make one of those. So, basic machine. Do I have one? No. We'll make one. Iron plates. We have a few. So we'll take iron plates with the, with this shit, makes that. We need 16 diamonds pulverized. There we go. And we need to make energium dust, then make those into things. So we need redstone, we need all 14. We probably need more. I actually have to take out my redstone that I was processing. It's this redstone. Alright, let's throw the redstone back through. So we have a bunch of cinnabar again, like so much cinnabar, more than I even need. Let's make... Okay, let's compress it. I thought I grabbed it out. Compressor, cool. It's like not even touching the power. Jesus, man. Okay, so yeah, I need to put in these. And what am I missing? Oh, the tin shits. Yeah. Over here. We have 40. Nice. So let's start making some more frames. I also want to make more resonant ones. Kind of just to have them. So I think I have everything. Let's get... what was I waiting for? Compressor. Okay. My power is amazing. Having actually, like, backed up power feels really good, honestly. You guys don't even know. You don't even know. Oops. What's this? We need gold cable. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's take this, put it there, put this here. And a basic. So we have an MFE. I need the extra gold cable. This is going to be interesting. Okay, so I'm basically going to go set this up. We need, like, cobble and maybe a crescent hammer. Cobble. I have the crescent hammer on me, so that's okay. Let's go. So 128 blocks right about here. So from the back here, we're going to set up the MFE. This will start getting power. Then we'll set up the spaces. So this. Which then it's the laser drill precharger, which actually you have to do it backwards. So you have to do, that's where it would be, this is that, this is the laser drill, so then we would angle it this way, and that'll face it now. So that'll get power once I obviously connect two HVs. Which, how does this have power? What? Oh, 'cause I held it in my hand. Okay, yeah. I don't know if I want focuses on it yet. So let's go get HV wire. HV. So we have this too, this. We need steel and treated wood. Let's get 10 and treated 6. Sure. Let's craft this ship. It's funny, I don't even look at the time of the video. I just know when it's around the time to end the video. Alright, so should be pretty simple to set this up. We just do this and this, and there we go. There's my power. You can see it going down. It's actually using a shit ton of power. It's going up on the energy bar. And then I have these focuses. So I kind of do want to make the focuses actually. It's light blue is what I need to do. So let's look what it is. Laser. It's a light blue one. This. So it's tons of gold nuggets, stained blue glass, which is ceramic dye, which is clay plus light blue dye, which is, I think, bone meal and lapis. Okay, let's do that first. Five of it. Plus lapis. We'll do five lapis. Okay, so we have light blue dye. Then I need to dye clay. So we need to take out 10 clay. That's pretty interesting. Okay, then we need to dye glass. So now we need to get glass. Is it just like this? Okay. And those six should be enough, but we're gonna make a few more. Okay. Then I make the panes. And then I say, well, let's put this shit back in the system, because I don't need it now. How the fuck? Okay, now that I have the panes, I need gold nuggets. Gold nuggets. 30. And emeralds. Okay, so we do this. This. And these in the middle. One, two, three, four. Let's put all this back. Lot of things. This, 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 this. Oh god, wait. I needed more. Gold. Oh wait, can't I just actually do this? Let's unlock this. Mate, get the fuck out of here. You should be in your. Fuck! That was the one thing I didn't need to do! Ah! Let's just take one of each. We'll set up the damn recipe again. Fuck me, dude. Okay. There, yes, this is what I was trying to do. You could pull out more. Okay, that's all I wanted to do, but I clicked the wrong fucking button and I was so mad. Alright, let's just put all this back in. I don't need any of that. Okay, let's go put the focus on. Also, we'll have to drill the hole. So maybe I should actually disable this for a second. I guess we'll leave the top block. Oh yeah, I haven't checked the actual spot yet. So let's get hover mode. So it's like it's the. All right, I think that's good. Let's drop down. So it's this block. Okay, so we'll come down right there. Do I have a shovel on me? No. It's okay. Oh god, my cable. My cable! Fuck. I'm gonna have to go around it. I have to get more cable. Gold. I think two should be fine to go around it. come down here. Gold cable, we're good. Let's go all the way down to bedrock now. Let's actually block this water off. Super annoying water. So just hope I don't find any lava. I don't really have the armor for this. Maybe I should hover mode it. So I don't know what to expect, actually. I don't hear lava. But who knows? There's bedrock. Okay, we're good. Let's get the hell out of here. So now I should just be able to remove this. Laser works. Now I need a chest, because now it's just going to be spitting out items. Chest. Hey, we have one right here. Okay, so when I go up there, I'm going to find items, probably. Also, a pink slime seems to be making a little bit of a mess. Maybe I should fix that. Has it created an item yet? No. But the work is going up, and how did I not get an item? Well, I guess 10 million, or the million wasn't even a one work yet. So now I want to check my, like, capacitors. So that's empty. That's going up. How the fuck? How is that possible? I'm still not using too much power? That's not even possible. It must be a joke. Oh, is it because this has power still? Yeah, it is going down now. Okay, so now I could turn on the reactor and feel fine, because I have a mining laser running at the same time now. Okay, now let's go check buffers and shit. So this is going up a lot. That's going up a lot. Obviously, those will fill first, and then this one will get the extra. So now we actually have something to kill extra power now, which you can see it going down pretty fast. This is actually limited to be 2,000 RFs a tick as it is, which basically covers the reactor. So we're just dumping the extra power I have into the mining laser, basically. Which, it's not dumping because it's actually useful. Look, I already got shiny ore. Ridiculous. So I should really, like, get a better chest for that. Maybe I should make an iron chest. Okay, let's get another chest and let's upgrade it. Okay. Iron. Let's get the plates. Gold. Let's get the plates. And I could even make a diamond chest with, like, I think it's this and then glass. Just a buttload of glass. I don't remember though. Yeah, it is. Okay. There we go. Let's replace this with a diamond chest. I also want to work on more power. So, That's really good, though. I also want a freaking ender quarry now. Because I could run that, but... Okay, and then how's this doing? There we go. Cool. What's in here? Pig iron? Oh. Yeah. It's also making blood, so that's a thing. But yeah, how much? 418. Yeah, that's pretty good. We're gonna keep this going because I actually need slime balls for that shit. So let's look up the emerald upgrade. Let's actually not look up emerald. Let's look up upgrade. Alright, so we need this. So we need more templates. We have two. Huh. What does it take to upgrade? Sticks and emeralds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, let's get sticks. Let's throw them in here. Put the emeralds in. There we go. That should be plenty of storage for this. I'm really not sure why they don't get stopped or they don't get pushed by the conveyor belts very well. Oh, he just snuck out. What a little bitch. Guess I need to block up the front too. There we go. I need to just put like a fan on the top of the thing and then put, yeah. Okay, let's get a fan. Let's make a fan, so it's iron, slabs, and iron fence. So easy. Iron fence. Or is it like that? Okay. Then we get a lever. Okay, we have a stick. Let's just do this. Okay. Let's just go up here. We'll put a fan on this thing. Like that. Okay, cool. So it's not turning off that, and the fan is working. So now it pushes them off, and we should be good to go, where it won't back up anymore. Okay. Right. Now we have shiny ore. Ooh. Ooh. Awesome. How's my miner doing? The advanced miner. It's very advanced. Lead, iron, coal, yellow, coal, uranium. So I think this uranium I'm going to process as uranium. Kind of have to at this point. So yeah, we're gonna like pulverize it. Let me make sure before I do this. Yeah, we're gonna pulverize it. And cook it. So red, yellow. We're gonna have tin, lead, yellow, right, silver, gold, iron. All in here. Same thing as before. All the coal. I could probably get the lapis processed as well. Might as well. Let's see how to process it. Redstone furnace, pulverizer is 12. Oh my god, that's crazy. So I would need to. Yeah, okay. We get sulfur out of this too. Yeah, hype. What is the appetite? 12 out of a pulverizer. Let's do that. Appetite. Yeah, we have a decent amount. Okay. Ore. What else do we have? Eh, everything else doesn't really matter to be processed right now. Yep. Okay. I'm curious. Wow. Nether, iron, appetite, iron. Not bad. This is gonna give me a lot of stuff, and specifically diamonds, hopefully. So that's like the main plan, is to get diamonds out of this. Which shouldn't be that hard. So I actually wonder, is this buffer? Yeah, it's going down. Okay, good. That's what I want. So we'll let that go. I could pretty much come back to more resources. I think the advanced miner alone gives me enough power to keep this running, like my entire setup. So I can keep that going and have no worry. We have so much redstone. What the hell? Also, like all this stuff in here, gotta throw that back in. My system's gonna have a meltdown. I really want a. Oh man. We have to iron out some kinks though first. Like, I'll need to make more power. Either more of these wind things or something else. Or at least we'll be having diamonds come in now. So either I make ME or I make more power and an ender quarry. Let's just look at this again. Doable. You already have one. Made one already. Made one already. Easy. Tesseract. Make it. So I can make an entire ender quarry. Can I make the QED? Yeah, I just need to make a resonant machine frame. So I need an Enderium gear and an intricate circuit. Okay, let's get one of these and let's get an Enderium gear. Alright. Let's go set this up. What am I. What? Oh, it's an emerald chipset. Yeah, I don't have one of those in there. Let's go get it. I think we're gonna make a few emerald chipsets. Might as well, you know. I'm also gonna like have to figure out the Is that good? Yeah. That'll take a it's sweet time. I have to figure out my gas tier problems again. So, just like last time. Hope you guys enjoyed, though. Leave a like if you guys did. Leave a comment in the comment section below about the progress and the nuclear reactor, what you guys think of my design and stuff. I'm really interested to see what you guys have to say. Subscribe if you guys are new to the channel, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Is that filling up with blood? Or are we good? A little bit of blood. I could actually take this out and replace it with just the casting table. And start pouring the blood as coagulated, which I can also use as slime balls. Yeah, I shouldn't be able to pour the pig iron out. And this is at 744. So kind of I could just leave my system. So yeah, take care and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.